What's up, everybody? Back with another Herbal Reactions, of course. And we're about to watch Outlander. I had somebody suggest this one to me a nice minute ago. yeah, I'm going to try to... These got a lot of episodes in it. This has 16 in it, so I'm going to try to get through these. And this one has like six seasons, so you know, I don't know, bro, how I'm gonna do this, because that's, I don't know, it's like, because Bel-Air, I just got finished with Bel-Air, and I'm just starting Gangs of London, and then I'm starting this one, so that's two shows. I'm not trying to do like 17 shows like I did before. I was doing like six shows and then trying to do music videos, so I'm probably going to do like a whole bunch of music videos and then do shows in between those, so it's like y'all always getting content and stuff. Because when I was doing the shows, you know, shows are like an hour long, 45 to an hour long, so, and if I watch two shows at a time, or you know, that's 2 hours or whatever, then I gotta edit that shit, you know, so I'ma slow down on the shows for a little bit. You know, I'm still watch my Outlander and Gangs of London, and if anything big comes out, I don't know, something trendy, I probably watch that shit too. So I'll probably do a total of like three shows at a time, maybe. I don't know, we'll see, because some of these shows I was kind of like, yeah, I don't want to watch this shit no more. But other than that, we're about to just hop right into this and just, you know, see where it takes us.
People disappear all the time. Young girls run away from home.
Oh, this
Children stray from the parents.
This gives me like a...
Housewives take the grocery money in a taxi to the train station.
The Witcher type feel. That's what it does. That's what it gives me.
Remember single images and feelings that stay with you down through the years, like the moment I'd realized I'd never owned a vase, that I'd never lived in any place long enough to justify having such a simple thing, and how at that moment I wanted nothing so much in all the world as to have a vase of my very own. It was a Tuesday afternoon, 6 months after the end of the war.
God damn. Brutal. Y'all just want me, y'all, yeah. This shit is real. God. Oh, I feel that. I feel that in my leg. Come on, man. Stop showing that shit. Stop showing that shit, bro. I'd have been pissed. Does this shit deal with magic? No, this shit does not deal with magic.
Did you hear? It's over. It's really finally over.
Is this World War II or I? I think this is two, but this could definitely be one. I think this is one. I think this is World War One.
Somehow in my mind, VE Day, the end of the bloodiest and most terrible war in human history, grows fainter with each part. There's two more over there.
Seems to be surrounded by homes marked with blood.
Perhaps Pharaoh has refused Moses and the spirit of death will travel the streets of Inverness tonight, sparing only those who mark their doors with lamb's blood.
Yeah, you may be closer than you think. It will be some sort of sacrificial ritual, but I suspect pagan rather than Hebrew.
No idea Inverness is such a hotbed of contemporary paganism.
I'm not even going to fake, guys.
Magic and superstition.
This is day in life is really common. Boring right now.
Shall we?
At first it was like, okay, like, alright, well, is there blood on the fucking wall? What the fuck? Oh yeah, I thought you was gonna scare me with that, huh?
It's an old custom at this time of year to make such a sacrifice to honor Saint Orion.
Ah, Orion. He was sainted in the 8th century?
You know your history.
I'm afraid my husband's the historian, Mrs. Baird. I'm quite happy.
Church often took pagan holidays, renamed them for their own purposes. Samhain became Halloween, Yule became Christmas, so on.
Well, you're both welcome at the festival, of course. Mine.
Interesting. Didn't know that. I might have to look that up one day.
When we have those for sure. I'll show you to your room.
Before the war, we were inseparable. But for the next 5 years, we saw each other a grand total of 10 days.
Dang, what?
Beats an army tent and a cot in the mud.
Till death do us part. That is real.
When the war ended, we both thought things would return to the way they once were. But they hadn't.
Having fun?
Mrs. Randall.
Probably jump on a... Y'all gonna break the shits. They're just jumping on a bed.
You know, one of those things I used to.
They would tell their kids, don't jump on the bed.
A million times before. It's the strangest thing.
I used to sketch this.
My hand?
Well, the lines, really. Why exactly, I'm not sure, but I had a very clear memory of this pattern. The little doodles everywhere. There's a brigadier once dressed me down because I drew it in the margin of a report for the minister.
Yeah, this is a little boring, guys. People's viewers.
Thank you.
So they gonna go into like another world or something? That's what I'm waiting for, because I'm that's why I haven't really been talking, because they doing their own thing and nothing really spectacular is happening. You know what I mean? I mean, it's the first episode.
What do you think this was used for?
From the lack of proper lighting and ventilation, I would say province of the castle hermit. Perhaps a troll or two.
I don't think trolls live in pairs. Solitary creatures, they.
More's pity. All this. No one to share it with.
You'll get dirty.
You can give me a bath.
A bath? Where? You want to get a bath? A bath? Okay, okay. Y'all gonna make love.
I do believe you left your undergarments at home.
Uh-oh, okay, about to gear the nitty gritty. Nom, nom, nom. I'm still bored. Not gonna lie.
Have a look.
Him? Is it Walter?
No, darling. Jonathan Wolverton Randall, finally.
Captain of Dragoons in the British Army and your direct ancestor.
Exactly. Otherwise known as Black Jack. Rather dashing nickname. He probably acquired while he was stationed here in the 1740s. The Reverend has found a series of army dispatches that mention the captain by name.
Ah, exciting.
It is.
Good to see all your sleuthing over the past week has paid off.
Yes, I was beginning to wonder.
It appears Black Jack commanded the garrison at Fort William for 4 years or so. Seems to spend quite a bit of his time harassing the Scottish countryside on behalf of the crown.
Well, it was not endeavor. Things were deeply throughout the Highlands in the 18th century.
Well into the 20th, it would seem. I distinctly heard the barman in the pub last night refer to us as Sassenach.
I hope you didn't take offence. It only means Englishman, after all, or at worst, outlander.
Mm. I've brought you a wee bit of refreshment, gentlemen. I brought but the two cups, for I thought...
This for Samhain tomorrow night.
For the pagan festival. Reverend Wakefield, you do astonish me.
I love a good ghost story as much as the next fellow.
Nice.
So is this a ghost story?
Do you try to get home before the storm breaks?
I will.
Little interesting. It's turning up a little bit. You know how when it get hot, and you or like when it's cold outside and you want to get hot, you turn it up a little bit. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah.
But what I didn't know at the time was that tomorrow would prove less important than yesterday.
Jesus H. Roosevelt
Christ.
What? I gotta say that one. Jesus H. Roosevelt Christ. Okay. We got a weird bum outside. being dumb.
Excuse me. Can I help you with something?
Okay. 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 At that point, I'd have been running. There's no no fucking way.
Frank, it's opened up, the whole place lit up by the time you got back. Darling, what's the matter?
There's a peeping Tom outside, and then when I talked to him, Frank, he vanished.
You look like you've seen a ghost.
He has.
I'm not really sure that I haven't. When he pushed past me, he was close enough that I should have felt him brush my sleeve as he passed, but I didn't. And I turned around to say something, and he'd gone. He just vanished.
Bruh. I'd have been running. But he been in the war, so he it different. Y'all know we been watching ghost movies since we was kids. We ain't playing about that. he don't know nothing about no ghosts. He probably heard ghost stories and stuff like that. But we been hearing that shit since day three at least.
When I saw that chap staring up at you, I thought he might be someone you had nursed. Someone who might be looking for you now. To reconnect. No. All I meant was that even if you had, it would make no difference to me. I love you, and nothing you could ever do could stop my loving you.
Ain't that what men supposed to be? I don't even know, bro. Nowadays, it's so fucked up. I don't know what men supposed to be. Like, she's just been unfaithful. But he was at war. You know what I'm saying? Animals.
Sex was our bridge back to one another.
I bet.
Where we always met.
Whatever
obstacles presented themselves during the day or night, we could seek out and find each other again in bed.
I bet y'all could.
As long as we had that, I had faith everything would work out.
Damn, it was that sacred back then, guys. Our motherfuckers just doing it just to do it.
That reminds me, I want to set an alarm.
No. I thought we weren't setting alarms in this trip.
Back, pluck a damn flower and vanish. I don't know. This shit's called Outlander, so I'm thinking they're gonna go somewhere. This shit is kind of boring. I'm not even gonna fake, guys. Like, sparked my interest a little bit, but this shit. supposed to pluck that. You really want to touch that?
Once, traveling at night, I fell asleep in the passenger seat of a moving car, lulled by the noise and the motion into an illusion of serene weightlessness. Then the driver took a bridge too fast, and I woke to see the world spinning outside the car windows, and the sickening sensation of falling at high speed. That is as close as I can come to describing what I experienced. But it falls woefully short.
Sun up. You mean we'll be riding all night?
Mm-hmm.
All night. The next one too, I reckon. And a fine time of year for a ride, though. True.
Oof. That would suck, wouldn't it? You will pick a flower, start hearing drums and shit, and touch a rock, and then now you're in a freaking 16th, maybe 12th, 13th century or whatever.
Lying in wait right now. It's a funny place for an ambush, right enough. Ghoul! Shoot! Ghoul! Ghoul! A halakamir, can cluck, feel them called a jerk. Cluck a hulich, marajas, and fial, lads.
Yeah, like halaka, sure.
Sure. Sounds like the bell, too, Rick.
Telling me exactly how and why you come to know there's an ambush up ahead.
I don't know, but I heard the redcoats use cotton and
where did you hear?
In the village.
Ah. You liar. The truth will come out soon enough. Oof. Run back to that rock and start picking flowers and touching rocks. If I was her, that's what I'd be doing. Go right back to that place, pick a flower, touch the rock. Because that's what I did. Well, that's what she did again, where, you know, yeah, I know. Not really into this. Not really. But I'll probably give it another episode.
Hope you haven't been misusing that shoulder. You're hurt.
This doctor's need my blood. Not much of it anyway. The Dougal and the others will be waiting further up the stream.
I'm not going with you.
Yes, you are.
What? Are you going to cut my throat if I don't?
I know.
that heavy.
Now, if you won't walk, I shall pick you up and throw you over my shoulder.
So they're going to show the husband.
Shot wound. Didier could have said something. It's a clean exit. I think the round's gone straight through the muscle. I don't think it's serious, but he's lost a lot of blood. It'll need to be disinfected before I can dress it properly.
Disinfect?
Yes, it must be cleaned of dirt to protect it from germs.
Germs? Ooh! Damn, she back in the day, boy! Nigga.
Welcome back.
I'm all right. Just a wee bit dizzy.
You're not all right. Can you tell how badly you were bleeding? You're lucky you're not dead, brawling and fighting and throwing yourself off horses. All right, I need a sterile bandage and some clean cloth. Jesus H. Roosevelt Christ.
Who? You gotta ask them what time you're in.
You mind your own bloody business, and so can St. Paul.
Oof.
And if you move so much as a single muscle while I'm tying this bandage, I'll bloody throttle you.
Threats, is it? And after I shared my drink with you.
15 miles to go yet. 5 hours at least, if not 7. It'll stay long enough for you to stem the bleeding and dress his wound, no more than that.
He needs rest. Did you hear me?
Randall.
The officer you encountered.
Uh-huh.
He won't give up so easily. He commands the redcoats hereabouts. I sent patrols out in every direction by now.
Shit. At that point, she probably the greatest freaking medical doctor there ever have been. Like, you just took someone from the 20th century and threw her back in the 13th century? I don't know what century it is, but I'm saying it's probably the 13th. Nah, it's not the 1300s. It's probably in the 16th century. This is probably 16th century. 13th century is way too far.
Didn't hurt much at the time.
But yeah.
Does it hurt now?
Aye.
Good. That's about all I can do.
It's either 15, 16, 17. Those three. I don't know which one. I'm voting for 15. But if she goes back to the 15, yeah, she's the greatest. Yeah. She knows things that people can't even dream of knowing. She was in a car. Come on. She was in a car. Guys. She had electricity. What are you talking about? Like, if she really, like, bro. Interesting. This is very interesting. That's all I can say. It was boring. Now it's coming along. I'll definitely give it another watch, another episode.
I've been here with Frank 2 days ago.
Mm-hmm.
Or was that in the future? How could I remember something that hadn't happened yet? So far, I've been assaulted, threatened, kidnapped, and nearly raped. And somehow, I knew that my journey had only just begun.
Wow. You know, she couldn't do much either. Like, if she created, like, electricity, or if she knew how to somehow create electricity at that time, they would look at her like, yeah, you're a witch. Kill this bitch. Gotta kill her. But I hope you liked the reaction. If you did, like and subscribe. Tell me what you think of this episode, or tell me what you want me to watch next. And as always, thanks for watching.